This video is going to look at different ways to blend objects and kind of some of the cool effects you can get with that. So you can blend objects to create or distribute shapes between two objects. You can also blend two open paths to create smooth transitions. You can combine blends of colors and objects. Now, once you create these blends, they are all treated as one object. If you move things around or edit, the blend is going to change. Now, you can expand the blend to divide those into distinct objects. Let's get started. I have created a zigzag shape here and here, and then I expanded the appearance of it. So notice there is no stroke, it's like a shape now, whereas these are strokes. And I want to show you the two different ways the blend tool can work. So first I'm going to select both of these, go over to my blend tool, and notice it switches to being able to see all of our anchor points. And basically I want to connect one anchor point with another anchor point. So let's see what this looks like. And look at that. So we've created a smooth blend between these two objects, and now it doesn't look like there's two objects. But if I select, I can then kind of move and adjust any of these anchor points, and things are going to move accordingly. So you can see how that blend changes right there. So you can use this to get some interesting 3D type of appearances. And as I change this object, that's changing the blend as well. So let's compare that with those shapes to strokes. So I'm going to do the same operation, but look what it did. It created a third shape. And so that shape color is exactly centered and it is right between those two color-wise. Now those are all grouped. So if I want to ungroup them, I need to shift command G and ungroup them and then also expand the appearance of them to create that. So two different ways of working with those. This also works the same with shapes. So if I have my two shapes selected, when I blend, it's going to create that third shape. If I take those shapes and I expand their appearance, it'll create that blend. Now, let's say you like the idea of having shapes, but you want several of them, so you want what are called steps. In that case, instead of using the blend tool, you're going to use blend as a menu item. And we'll do that through object, blend, and make. And so if we want to change those options, we're going to go into blend options, and that was our smooth color. Let's do specific steps. So now when we create this, we're going to have 8 steps between these two hearts. And as we grab these and ungroup and then expand them, now we have separate objects. So I can come in and select all of my different colors of my hearts and do whatever I want with those. So those are two ways to create blends. Have fun with that technique.